Hi folks, Anarchy in the Brew K here again, and today I'm going to have another brew day with my long-awaited Richies Simply Lager, which I've been eager to do. Now I've got the time to do it, and I've had a little read on the back. There's no ABV on it, so I don't know what kind of strength it's meant to come out as, but I just hope it ain't going to be one of those weak ones, so I may just do 36 pints of it. I don't like anything under 4%, that's definitely, well, particularly I don't like anything under 4.5%. Anything over that, that's fine with me. Right, okay then. I'll keep on brewing and making lager until I get it right. Just like this song. Let's go. Okay folks, well, I'm ready to rock and roll. The Simply. Simply smells simply gorgeous, that's for sure. Ew. In we go, Simply. I did put the Simply in some hot water for 10 minutes. I'm going to put a pint of boiling water. In here to get out the rest of that lovely extract. Which I just happen to have here, right next to me. Shake about. To shake them back. Oh yeah, that's coming out nice and easy now. Stuff is sticky. That'll do. I mean, come on. Come on. I'm not expecting it to be sparkling clean in there. That'll do. Right. Next on the agenda, folks, is our 1 kg of dextrose sugar. In that goes. Lovely jubbly. Let's give that a quick. Looks like that. And get in 5 pints of boiling water. Actually, I think I should have put the 5 pints of boiling water in first. Sweet. Sweet. I don't suppose it matters. Once that boiling water goes in there, everything dissolves. Now I'm just going to use normal Sainsbury's spring water, 20p a bottle, and I can use the bottle for bottling the brew with. And I don't even have to sterilise the bottle because it's already sterilised. Doesn't that sound good? Straight back on, no fuss. Mm-hmm. and so forth. Give that a quick stir. But you don't want to see all that, so I'll get back to you when it's a bit fuller. Okay, we're on 36 pints of liquid in there now. Lovely liquid out of that. Stir. Okay, I want to get my hydrometer and take a little reading. A minute. Okay, well, it appears we're on the 1.040. I mean, I ain't got the greatest device when it comes to looking at these little numbers, but I took a good close-up look without the camera, and yeah, that's how it appears to me. And yeah, that's. Yeah, 1.040, which could be a possible 5.1 ABV. Hopefully, that would be respectable. Okay, be pitching time. Okay, folks, it's yeast pitching time. Nothing I can really say about this yeast. It don't have no numbers on it or anything like that. It just says beer yeast, and that's it. Okay, let's open that up. Now, my temperature is below 25, it's at 23 at the moment. If I can keep a constant temperature between 20 and 25 degrees, then it should take about 8 days for the fermentation to stop. Okay, let's give that a little dab, a little stir. Just like the instructions show. I suppose that'll do. Okay folks, here she is. I've just put water in the airlock, so, and now she's in her resting place for 8 days. Until then, that's the way that goes. Anything else for me to say? Well, actually, I've got hops on my plants now. So, let's go and have a little look at those. Unfortunately, the target failed me. And I've got a feeling it could be because I left it in a grow bag and I should have taken it out and put it into the ground, but I didn't. So you learn. You learn by your mistakes. Anyway, no matter how many YouTube videos you watch on these things, you know, until you actually do it yourself, you really sort of get an idea. But look, there's some little ones coming up there, and I've got some. They're going all the way up here. Yeah, this is the yeoman. Yeah, you see that? Hops, I mean, there's not, it's only the first year, so there's not a great amount of them, but there'd be enough to do a bit of flavouring. Yep, the old yeoman. And over here we have the bramling cross. So,
right, bramling across. Look at that, see. Now they're not bad, are they? They're a reasonable size, first year. And there's quite a few on them. Look at that tasty little bugger. I mean, this one'll be on there for a few on there for a bit of flavouring as well. And next year, my setup would be completely different. Completely different, as I say. No matter what you watch and you think you've learned on YouTube, until you've actually do it for yourself and you see the mistakes that you make. Yeah. All right. Okay. Let's hop along. Okay. So I kind of guess that concludes today. I've still got my Brew Buddy cider. I haven't tasted that yet. Well, that's been barreled now for about a month, I guess. I'll be having a pint of that on the 5th of November, Guy Fawkes Night. So that's barreled and that's in storage in a nice dark cool cupboard, just to hopefully mature a bit. I've got some Connoisseur Pilsner to do, and I've got Harvester Lager to do as well. But what I really want to do next is some more bitter, because I do like bitter. And I'm going to do two kits together, you know, like do a 60 or 70 pinter. And put that away for Xmas. Okay, guys, thanks for watching. Bye. Well, folks, it's been about 20 hours since pitching the yeast. And, yep, she is blowing. She's just a bit camera shy. But, hold up, here we go, here we go. There she blows. So, yeah, I'm happy with that. It's a good healthy at the moment. A good healthy bubble going on there. Not frantic, but yeah. Let's have one more. Going, come on. Here it goes. There she blows. Good stuff.